And what is going on, everybody? My name is Travis, and welcome to SF Bay Area Sports Talk. Hope everyone's having a fantastic day today. The Chicago Bulls suffer another frustrating loss, 125-106, against their division rival, Indiana Pacers. And this is now the second back-to-back game that we have gotten blown out in, falling behind by as many as 40 points in the season opener against the Hawks. And in this one, we fall behind by as many as 30 points against the Pacers. And this is so incredibly frustrating when the game is essentially already over in the third quarter. And the Pacers in this one went on a 33-15 run in that third quarter to put away this game. And this is tough. This is not how we wanted to start the season. You know, Billy Donovan, new coach, wanting, again, getting a feel for all of his players and finding out the strengths and weaknesses of everyone. And, you know, so it's still early, but nonetheless, this is a tough loss to take. And again, I have a lot of confidence in this young Bulls team. I really think we can string together some wins this year and make the playoffs. Now let's break down the stats of this game. Your leading scorer for your Bulls was Zach LaVine with 17 points. He was 3 of 6 from three, and we saw another tremendous performance from Lauri Markkanen tonight. He added 16 points with 9 rebounds, and that is now back-to-back great starts for Markkanen, and this is huge. I've said I think he's going to have a bounce-back year this year, have a big season, and that would be really huge because he had 2 great seasons his first 2 years, but then last year kind of took a step back, wasn't as aggressive on the basketball court. So you love to see that getting off to a tremendous start this season, and you love to see him playing to his potential out there, and he's going to be absolutely huge. And we saw today a couple of returns from injuries, so that's always tremendous to hear. Garrett Temple made his Bulls debut tonight. He had 6 points, 3 assists, and 2 steals. And we also saw, returning from injury, Denzel Valentine. He had 11 points, and he was 3 of 4 from 3 in this game. Valentine is a huge guy coming off the bench and is a guy that I would like to see start. And we'll see if, you know, I'm sure Donovan will mix in, get him a lot of starts. And I really think he can play very well and be a really good player. So we'll see what ends up happening. Kobe White had a great game with 12 points. So not a big game, but, you know, decent. And he was 4 of 7 from 3. Really got hot in that first quarter. He hit 4 threes, I believe it was. So Kobe White, I think, is going to have a big season in his sophomore year. He is such an exciting talent out there, and last year gave us so many exciting moments and thrills and put up big games, and, you know, was averaging 25 points a game, you know, the last 20 or so games of last season. So Kobe White's going to be a lot of fun to watch this season. Now, also, Thomas Sadorowski added 9 assists in this game. The rookie Patrick Williams had 9 points in this game. He is another player that I am incredibly excited to see. Kind of reminds me a lot of a young Kawhi Leonard. And so I think the ceiling is as high. The sky is
stretch the floor. He can defend. He can score efficiently. And so I'm really incredibly excited to see what he accomplishes in his rookie season.
Now, Wendell Carter Jr. added 9 points tonight with 6 rebounds, 2 assists, and 2 blocks. Otto Porter Jr. added 10 points in the game. So again, you know, the Bulls put up some offense tonight, but the defense let us down, and, you know, we cannot keep getting blown out. So it's going to be huge for us to start playing better basketball. And I know this Bulls team has it within itself. So it's going to be, we got to get after it. And it's going to be a fun one coming later today.
The Bulls are going to be taking on my second favorite team, the Golden State Warriors. And this is, of course, my favorite matchup of the year. Every year, whenever the Bulls and Warriors get together, they play 2 times a year. And usually every year I go to the Bulls Warriors game. Of course, it's always been in Oakland at Oracle Arena, but now with the Warriors having moved to San Francisco to the beautiful Chase Center, that is this game, of course, is going to be played in Chicago.
So I'm incredibly excited to watch this game, so we'll see if the Bulls can get their first victory of the season. The Warriors also have been struggling, having gotten blown out their first couple of games, so they are off to an 0-2 start as well. So we'll see what's going to happen in this one, and it's going to be so much fun. And so with that being said, thank you so much for checking out today's video. And if you enjoyed this video, hit that thumbs up button to show your support. Thank you so much, everyone, for all your tremendous support, smashing that like button, commenting on the videos, sharing the videos. It means so much to me, and it really helps out the channel. So thank you so much again. You guys are truly the real MVPs out there. And be sure to smash that subscriber button if you haven't done so, so you can be notified when brand new videos are being posted on all the latest sports breaking news, game breakdowns, and fan reactions. And be sure to smash that notification bell so you can be notified as soon as my videos are being posted. Otherwise, YouTube is not going to let you know when my videos are coming out. So if you subscribe to the channel, be sure to hit that notification bell. Otherwise, then yeah, I mean, you're subscribing, but how are you going to know and be in the loop when all the latest news is coming out? So that being said, thank you so much again. Feel free to let me know down below in the comment section, what were your thoughts, Bulls fans, on this game against the Pacers? I thought we did play better than we did against the Hawks, but again, we got to start winning some games. So would love to hear all your thoughts and perspectives on what you've seen the first couple of games to start the year. So cannot wait. And as always, until next time, we'll see you all right back here at SF Bay Area Sports Talk. Have a fantastic day, everyone. Strive for greatness.